Gemini 3 Pro is here, and with it, the AI agents we've been waiting for. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and on this channel, I share a ton of Gemini content just like this. And today we're gonna jump into Gemini's most intelligent model yet. And we are also going to cover some things that come with it, like diving into how to use an AI agent in Gemini. We've got a lot to cover. I should preface this by saying Gemini 3 is available in the Google AI Studio as well as Google Search. But for today, we're gonna focus on inside the Gemini app specifically, and even more specifically with Gemini 3 Pro inside the Gemini app. Gemini 3 Pro is Google's latest and most advanced AI model. It is designed for superior reasoning and multimodal capabilities across text, images, audio, and video. And Google says Gemini 3 Pro inside the Gemini app is going to supercharge how you learn, create, plan, take action, analyze videos, and more. Seriously, as of right now, Gemini 3 is the best model in the world for multimodal understanding. So let's go over some of the updates you can expect in Gemini. First, Nano Banana Pro is now available on Gemini 3 Pro. Yes, so that means Nano Banana Pro is gonna give us better control over our images and better text rendering with the images, which we've all been asking for. Amen. I'm making a full video on Nano Banana Pro and all you can do with it and the differences now with this update, but just know that this is one of the upgrades with Gemini 3 Pro. So, in Gemini, under your models dropdown in the prompt bar, you're going to notice a thinking mode, and this is the thinking with Gemini 3 Pro that thinks through more complex topics. You might also notice a bunch of buttons under the prompt bar. This may be similar to the tools you can enable here. But for now, let's do a simple prompt with Gemini 3 Pro to just show you the improved capabilities. So we're gonna ask Gemini 3 Pro to please explain how to play Mahjong. Seems to be all the rage these days. And here we go. We've got Gemini showing its thinking. We've got the goal of the game, the tiles, the setup, gameplay loop, winning, and then even key variations. This is pretty detailed. So now let's go ahead and in our tool dropdown, why don't we head into Canvas? And then let's ask Gemini 3 Pro to write the rules for the American variation for us. We're gonna hit enter. And we're gonna let Canvas with Gemini 3 Pro go to work here. And now we've got our prompts on the left, just like we're used to in our Canvas view, and then our full canvas on the right with all of the American rules. Now from here, you can create a web page or audio overview or more. You can click the share button to share this right to Google Docs. And I've got a whole video linked in the description that covers Canvas and more. But now that we've got a lay of the land with Gemini 3 Pro, let's cover how to use AI agents in Gemini. Because not to be dramatic, but this update is going to be a productivity game changer. So you might be thinking, what is an AI agent? What are we even talking about here? An AI agent is a system that is designed to execute a task on your behalf with your permission, and they act with intent. So think having an AI agent to do things for you, like sort your emails, manage a budget, organize or plan a trip, and so on. There are a ton of things AI agents can do. So the first thing that you should do is head to your settings and your connected apps. Here you're gonna wanna connect any apps you need or you'd like to access directly from Gemini if you haven't done so already. So with that done, let's open up a new chat window. And from here, let's head into our tools menu again in the prompt bar and this time select agent. Now, if you've not used agent before, you're gonna read through this little pop-up here that tells you this is the early stages and that you are indeed opting into this. So hit yes, I'm in, to start creating AI agents in Gemini. Now let's ask Gemini to find me a dinner reservation for 5 people for the best Italian restaurant in Old Town Scottsdale. Now I'm being purposely very vague here because I really wanna see how it does for me and the steps it takes. I'm not telling it what restaurant, what date, what time I want the reservation for. Let's see how it does. So it's processing my request by first trying to determine what the best restaurant is. It's gonna look up reviews and the like. And here we go. It has pulled up a couple of options and then it's asking me some follow-up questions like, obviously, which restaurant do I prefer? What is the preferred date and time? So this is the perfect type of query if you're traveling somewhere and you have no idea where to go for dinner or what the best Italian restaurant is. And instead of you wasting a bunch of time manually looking up and sorting through reviews and comparing all the restaurants, you can just have a Gemini AI agent do it for you. But I can also change my request completely here too. So let's actually say, you know what? Look into Luna for December 11th around 7 p.m. That's all I'm gonna give it. I've totally changed my mind. And check out what's happening here. It's grabbing the restaurant details. So it's figuring out, okay, what Luna is, where Luna is. And now it's navigating reservation options from Open Table. And it has opened this canvas view here. And look at this. I can see exactly what it's doing in Open Table that is trying to find me a table for Luna. And I can take control of this screen if I want, but I would like Gemini to continue the heavy lifting on my behalf right here inside Gemini. This is wild. So look what's happening here. It's selecting my preferred date and time, and now it's selecting the right amount of people from the dropdowns in Open Table. It is literally acting on my behalf. Holy moly. I have sped this up a little bit for you, but I cannot believe what is happening here. This agent is literally doing the work of making the reservation for me. And even though I did speed it up like a hair, this all happened in literally under 2 minutes. Like, I mean, I understand it. It's doing literally exactly what it's supposed to do, acting on my behalf. But this is mind-blowing to actually see it in action. Now for your reference, here's where I stopped the process. It indeed found my exact reservation and has asked me if it would like to book the 7 p.m. for me. I'm not going to say yes right now since I don't actually want to have to book a reservation and then cancel it, but can you believe? I mean, I guess I could have the AI agent cancel the reservation for me as well, but you get the idea here. I'm shook. The future is here. So now let's try a bit of a different example and see how well a Gemini AI agent helps me with some subscription budgeting and organization. With agent toggled on, let's ask Gemini to go through my email and tell me what subscriptions I have and how much they cost me every single month. So the same process is happening here. It's figuring out what subscription I have. It's searching my Gmail for me. Now this could take me literally probably hours to scour through my emails, figure out what I have. So having this do it for me in a matter of minutes is pretty neat. It's reviewing all of the data and it's calculating the totals automatically. Who wants to bet it might find some subscriptions I've forgotten about? Ooh. So all in all, this took about 4 minutes to process task info, search my emails, verify subscription details, and calculate the totals. Once again, we get a canvas-like view and a full subscription and cost analysis is generated. Right at the top, I have my average monthly cost that I'm spending on subscriptions. If I scroll down, I can see it's all broken down. So my Google Photos fee per month, my yearly fees that it's averaged out per monthly cost basis on things like my workout app and screencasting software, password manager, and more. And then it's even got our wine membership and it notes that that is kind of random. It's periodic for sure. And then look at the bottom. It's even got my canceled Spotify membership and when I canceled it. This is awesome. Now let's talk availability, and I'm gonna read it directly for you so I don't get it wrong. So when it comes to Gemini 3, this is available to everyone in the Gemini app, and Gemini 3 Pro is available to Google AI Ultra subscribers. I believe you get 500 prompts per day, and Google AI Pro subscribers get up to 100 prompts per day. Now, Gemini 3 Deep Think Mode is only available to Google AI Ultra subscribers, up to 10 prompts per day. Are you following along? And as you saw at the beginning of this video, agent mode in Gemini is still in its infancy, and please be sure to only connect apps that you trust and browse sites that you trust. So that's how to use AI agents in Gemini. What do you want to do with your AI agents in Gemini? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or you can leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Gemini goodness. You know you wanna. Thanks for watching. See you next time.